Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah wa nastaghfiruhu wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlilhu fala hadiya lahu. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم استغفر الله إن الله غفور رحيم إن الله غفور رحيم بلغ العلا بكماله كشف الدجى بجماله حسنت جميع خصاله صلوا عليه وآله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. Respected brothers and sisters and dear viewers, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given us tawfiq to spend some time. Let's say Alhamdulillah. As you know, our time is running out. As you see, only one more day left and the holy month of Ramadan is over and we didn't finish. So I have another program, so we decided today to talk briefly about Sayyidina Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam, Hajrat Ayub alayhi wa salatu wa salam, to remind you and to refresh for Ibrah. But as you know, Sayyidina Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam, Quran mentioned he was a prophet. He was sent to the people in Iraq, Minawa, the name of the area, where used to live 100,000 people. So he was sent as a Nabi to the people in Iraq, where they had 100,000 people used to live. As a prophet, you know, he was giving da'wah to them. La ilaha illallah. The universal message. Each and every prophet, messenger, they used to convey to their people, worship none but Allah. La ilaha illallah. Allah is our sustainer. Allah is our protector. Allah, He is all in all. He is in control of everything. He is the one who gives you life and takes away. He is the one who gives you disease and who gives you cure. So everything belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is our Rabb. So he was telling, giving dawah to these people. You know, as people were not listening to him. As usual, you know, people try to stay with what they are doing. They are following the Iblis. You know, they are following the batil of their forefathers and they are not listening to the da'wah of Sayyidina Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam, the Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was doing his job, but at the end, you know, he became frustrated. He became very upset with his people because they are not accepting his da'wah. They are not accepting his religion. So he decided to go far away from that place and to go another place to give them dawah. And he was thinking maybe those people might accept his preaching, accept his dawah. So he tried to go away from them. He went to cross the ocean and there was a ship. He went to the ship and, you know, there was some people decided to throw their stuffs into the ocean, into the sea. But still it was not helping. So they decided, okay, let somebody has to get out of this ship, otherwise we all will be dying. So they made a lottery. Whose name comes, he will go. He will jump, he has to jump into the sea. Imagine, lottery. The name that came up is the name of Hazrat Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam. But everybody in that ship, they know him as a righteous, pious person. So they said, no, something wrong with this lottery. So they try to do it again. And his name came back again, third time again. Sayyidina Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam. He jumped into the ocean, jumped into the sea. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded, ordered whale fish to swallow Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam. And then another fish swallow Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam. Imagine the whale fish and Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam in the stomach of that big fish. And as you know, they swallow and they have so many. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the fish. He's not to swallow him, but not to Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam. He went to the bottom of the ocean. Initially he thought that he's already dead, but then he realized he heard at the bottom of the ocean zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The voice of the zikr. And Jibril Amin told animals, fish, everything at the bottom of the ocean, they are all doing zikr. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah. Sabbaha lillahi ma fis samawati wa ma fil ard. Everything around, all this creature, they are making sujood, they are praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we, as a human being, we have problem. We don't have some time to turn around and make zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are so busy with our worldly life. We are so busy with unnecessary things. But we are not doing things that we should do. So Sayyidina Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam, he realized, and then he made his famous dua. La ilaha illa anta. La ilaha illa anta. Subhanaka inni kuntu min az-zalimin. Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam, he realized, he admitted his guilt that, you know, he left the area without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was sent there, his mission over there, but without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he left the area. That was his fault. He said, La ilaha illa anta. Subhanaka inni kuntu min az-zalimin. And he's making dua that if Lord doesn't help him, doesn't forgive him, then he's in trouble. Subhanallah. He's asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. And he said, My Lord, I am making zikr of you in that place. Nobody ever has done it. In the three darkness, in the darkness of the stomach of the whale fish, in the darkness of the ocean, in the darkness of the night. Three darkness. And he was making his dua. La anta subhanaka inni kuntu min az-zalimin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded to his dua right away. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned very clearly in the Quran that this prophet this servant of mine, when he was in good health, when he has good time, he always remember me. And, you know, his zikr by the angels to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a light. You know, every time you make zikr, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a light, it goes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if Yunus would not remember me at his good time, when he has good time he had, when he was, you know, healthy, when he didn't have any problem, he remembered me day and night. So right now he's in trouble, he's in the three darkness, and he's asking my help. I forgave him. He's the only one who could rescue him from that, you know, stomach of the wildfish. The wildfish and Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam get out. Subhanahu wa ta'ala made a tree, small, some mention, it's like a loud tree in Bengali. All his skin peeled off, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cured him slowly, slowly. He went back to his people, and all his people this time accepted his deen. Everybody accepted La ilaha illallah, and they became Muslim. This is very interesting. The punishment was hovering. The punishment was already there. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took that punishment away because they accepted Islam. Subhanallah. This is the only nation, you know, their punishment was taken away and they had good time. Hazrat Yunus alayhi wa salatu wa salam was very happy. Subhanallah. Sahaba-i kiram asked the question to our beloved messenger, that dua is applicable to us. He said, yes. Yes. Any mu'min, whenever he's in big trouble, if he makes his dua, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min az-zalimin. Subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept and he will give the remedy of your problem if you really do this. Subhanallah. But the condition that, you know, you have to, when you have good time, when you are in good health, when you are young, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you will be in trouble, we have problem, difficulty, sickness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right away will respond to your dua. This is the short story of Sayyidina Yunus alayhi wa salatu wasalam. We'll continue our discussion. We'll talk about Sayyidina Ayub alayhi wa salatu wasalam, in English called Job. And the whole story of Sayyidina Ayub alayhi wa salatu wasalam was mentioned. He's an example of sabr. Subhanallah. That story was mentioned in the Quran, not like about preaching and his people, just to set an example. Sayyidina Ayyub alayhi wa salatu wa salam, he's a burning example for sabr. Subhanallah. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned his story. The story of Sayyidina Ayyub alayhi wa salatu wa salam, the Sayyidina Ayyub alayhi wa believers. Sayyidina Ayyub alayhi, he was a Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him everything. He was a very rich person. He was very wealthy. He had very good health. And he had children. You see, in this we need wealth. Al-malu wal-banuna zinatul hayati dunya wal-baqiyatu salihatu khayru inda rabbi yamada. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the beauty of this life. You know, with children and wealth, money. You see, every time, everywhere, money, wealth, and children are the beauty of this life. Al mal wal banun zinatul hayati dunya. But Sayyidina Ayyub alayhi wa salatu wa salam, and he has good health. If you have a lot of money, but if you are sick, if you have underlying disease, you'll not be able to enjoy anything. So good health is a very important factor. is a ni'amah. Good health is a ni'amah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes we don't realize that. Each and every part of our body, when we are in good health, we don't realize. When we get sick, we understand that health is wealth. Everybody admits that health is wealth. You cannot compare. You know, the people of Gruzi, they used to say, you know, if we have good health, you can buy everything. Subhanallah. So Sayyidina Ayub alayhi wa salatu wa salam, he had everything. He had good health, he had wealth, he had children. Subhanallah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to annama khalaqnakum abasa. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to test Ayub alayhi wa salatu wa salam. So all his children, they were dying, and he had patience. Because these children from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and now Allah is taking them, so he has sabr. Subhanallah. You know, he started losing his wealth. Okay, alhamdulillah. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gave me wealth. Now he's taking away. Alhamdulillah. And third thing, the health. So he became sick with leprosy. Leprosy is such a disease. Everybody is scared. It's an infectious disease. You know, today we have coronavirus. It's such a contagious infectious disease. And you see what's going around. With all your protection, using even N95, even the nurses, doctors, and the relatives, loved ones. Why? Because they are afraid they can get this disease from you. So when Sayyidina Ayyub alayhi wa salatu wa salam got leprosy, everybody is well known, this disease is well known, so including his wife. And he said, that's fine, you can leave, subhanallah. But only one wife, Rahima, subhanallah. She's an example for our sister that we need such a wife. She will not go away. She said, I am staying with you. I will take care of you. I cannot leave you at this time. Subhanallah. Imagine. Such a righteous woman. She was not worried that I'll get this disease and I'll die. No. Her main duty to take care of her husband. Subhanallah. Ayyub alayhi wa salatu wa salam. You know, he had patience. And years after years going passing by. And he was taken out of the city, far away. His wife, Rahima, people's house, food. You know, she used to work and get some food for her husband, for herself. When people used to know that she's going to that person who is sick with leprosy, they said, no, don't come to us anymore. And his wife, Ayyub alayhi wa salatu wa salam, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me good health for all these years. So, you know, now I'm sick. I have to show my gratitude. That many years, and then I'll make dua. Sayyidina salatu wa salam, he was showed his patience all along. But even his relatives, even wife, everybody started talking that if he was such a Nabi, righteous person, and now, you know, why Allah is not helping him? Why is all these things happening to him? All kinds of, you know, things people are talking about him, blaming him. At certain Ayyub alayhi wa salatu wa salam, he made his dua. Rabbi anni masani adhurru anta arhamur rahimin. Look at this dua, subhanallah. Sayyidina Ayyub alayhi wa salatu, Rabbi anni masani adhurru anta arhamur rahimin. Such a short dua, but look at the content of the dua. It's telling, my Lord, distress, suffering has touched me from all sides. You know, and you are so merciful, subhanallah. Rabbi anni masani adhur wa anta arhamur rahimin. That's it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his dua right away. And Allah told him, you know, hit the ground with your feet and the divine water started gushing out. And he washed his body. All this rash related to leprosy, everything gone, subhanAllah. His wife came back and she couldn't recognize him. You know, she couldn't recognize him. Ayub, you know, he's back to his normal state, subhanAllah, right away, because he passed the test. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was testing him, and now he passed. He showed his patience all along. And then asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbi Masani al-Dhurru Anta Arhamur Rahimin. Allah cured him. Leprosy is gone. He didn't have to go to any doctors. And look at this, the wife who took care of him for years, and she didn't get that disease. As a believer, وَإِذَا مَرِضْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِي. I believe in that Allah who gives you disease and who cures you. And this is the example. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Ayub alayhi salatu wasalam this disease, and it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cures him. He didn't have to take any pills. He didn't have to do anything. رَبِّ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الظُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ رَحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. Brothers, this is the power of dua. الدُّعَى مُخُّلِينَ. Sayyidina Ayub alayhi wa salatu wa salam shower. And what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down gold pouring to him, and he was collecting. He said, my Lord, I need it more. Subhanallah. So he got his wealth and he back his family, more children. It mentioned maybe 20 children. Subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him and he showed his patience. So brothers and sisters, the month of Ramadan is also a month for us to train ourselves for sabr. Inna Allaha ma'as sabirin. Inna Allaha ma'as sabirin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who have patience. We need to, end of this month of Ramadan, the holy month, we need to ask ourselves question that did I get, you know, my training of patience is little up or is down or same level. We need to, innahu may yattaqi wa yasbir inna allaha la yusinin. You need taqwa and patience. If we have two things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you in this life and after life. You will be successful. So Sayyidina Ayub alayhi wa salatu wa salam is an example of patience. Years after years, subhanallah, and he had. So we learn from this, from his story, that sabr is so important for us. We will have problems in our life. You know, we will lose our children. We will lose our business, loss in business. You know, so many things will happen, but we need to have patience and sabr. Ay taqaltu ala Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will return all wealth, health, family to Sayyidina Ayub alayhi wa salatu wa salam. Inshallah, with sabr, we'll be successful in our life and after life. Inna Allaha ma'as sabirin. Brothers, sisters, let's make short dua. صلى الله على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم أستغفر الله إن الله غفور رحيم أستغفر الله ربي من كل ذنب وأتوب إليه أستغفر الله إن الله غفور رحيم صلى الله على آله وأصحابه وسلم اللهم آمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وقينا عذاب القبر وقينا عذاب الحشر وقينا عذاب يوم القيامة اغلق قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك الرحمة إنك الوهاب آي الله پروردگار عالم پবিত্র মাস শেষতে যাচ্ছে মাহবুব আয় আল্লাহ আমাদের সিয়াম সাধনাকে তুমি কবুল করো আয় আল্লাহ তোমার হাবিব বলেছেন যারা রমজান মাস পেয়ে যদি তাদের আয় আল্লাহ গুনাহকে যদি মাফ করাইতে না পারে তাদের মতো হতবাগা নেই মাহবুব আমাদেরকে হতবাগাদের লিস্ট অন্তর্ভুক্ত করো আয় আল্লাহ তুমি আমাদেরকে মাফ করে দাও আয় আল্লাহ আস্তাগফিরুল্লাহ ইন্নাল্লাহ গফুরুর রহিম আয় আল্লাহ আমাদের মাতা পিতাকে মাফ করো আল্লাহুম্মা রাব্বিরহামহুমা কামা রাব্বায়ানি সাগীরা আয় আল্লাহ আমাদের ছেলেমেয়েদেরকে নামাজি ফরজ দিন এবং দুনিয়া আর বড়াই দান করো। রব্বি জালনি মুকিমাস সালাত ওয়া মিন যুররিয়্যাতি রব্বানা ওয়া তাকাব্বাল দুআ। আয় আল্লাহ আমরা যে যেখানে আটকা পড়ে গেছি তুমি আমাদেরকে সাহায্য করো। আয় আল্লাহ এই মহামারী থেকে উদ্ধার করেছিল আজকে। আয় আল্লাহ তুমি আমাদেরকে উদ্ধার করো মাহবুদ, করোনা ভাইরাস বিপদ থেকে মাহবুদ। আয় আল্লাহ আমাদের পক্ষ থেকে কোটি কোটি সালাত আর সালাম শোনার মদিনায় পৌঁছে দাও। আয় আল্লাহ তোমার হাবিবের অন্তর দিয়ে আমাদের অন্তর বরফ করে দাও। আয় আল্লাহ আমাদেরকে তোমার খাঁটি গোলাম হিসাবে কবুল করো। আয় আল্লাহ আয় রব্বুল আলামিন আয় পরওয়ারদিগার আলম তুমি ছাড়া আমাদের সাহায্যকারী কেউ নাই। হাসবুনাল্লাহ ওয়া নিয়মাল ওয়াকিল ফা নিয়মাল মাওলা ওয়া নিয়মান নাসির ওয়া সাল্লাল্লাহু তাআলা আলা খায়রি খালকি মুহাম্মাদিন ওয়া আলিহি ওয়া আসহাবিহি আজমাইন বিরাহমাতিকা ইয়া আরহামার রাহিমিন। থ্যাংক ইউ ফর ওয়াচিং। আসসালামু আলাইকুম।